Hi everybody, today I would like you to give you a brief introduction about what is good governance. When the group is too large for everyone to be involved in the decision making process, it creates an entity to facilitate the process. As everyone knows that, in an organization, the entity is the board of directors and members delegate the bulk decision-making to the boards, which will then delegate the implementation of those decisions to the staffs. Okay, so what is governance? Governance is the rules and practices by which the boards of directors ensures accountability, transparency and fairness in the decision-making process. Now, as you know that, good governance is the relevant and the robust process for meeting the confident and timely decisions. Good governance gives you a confidence in decision motives and needs about the decisions. Like it gives trust and respect to the other peoples, and it also ensures the leader's decision making. Now, what governance determines to us? Governance determines that who has a voice in making the decisions, who is accountable, and how the decision is made. Now, as you know that, the works for the governance, they are defined in the association in other governance document. However, it is the norms and actions of association leaders that determines the effectiveness of the governance.
Now, what are the parameters of good governance? Or how good governance can flourish our society and nation? As everyone knows that if governance can cover social, political, economic, administrative, democratic aspects that a government is meant for, then that is good governance. In good governance, there will be no excuses for not helping poor gain assets. There will be no excuse to reduce wage and gender gap and many other gaps. There will be no excuse for not being able to curb leaks or corruption. There will be ways to find it to do so. We humans have few basic needs: food, water, air, proper shelter, energy, means to gain such resources, health security, money, etc. are a part of these requirements.
Concept of good governance emerges mainly because of the practices of bad governance, characterized by corruption, unaccountable government and lack of respect for human rights, have become increasingly dangerous, and the need to intervene in such cases has become urgent. The main characteristics of good governance includes: it is accountable, it is transparent, it follows the rule of law, it is responsive, it is equitable and inclusive, it is effective and efficient, it is participatory.
The advantages of good government: it promotes community confidence, it leads to better decisions, it helps local government to meet its legislative responsibilities, it supports ethical decision.
Talk about India, it really lacks good governance. The core proof is the tag "developing country" to India. We can say corruption is one of the biggest enemy of development, which highly shows lack of good governance in our country.
Lack of good governance has led to worse scenario. The unhygienic scenario of the country can speak, learn the words.
Question arises: how good governance can flourish our society? Well, better quality and cost-effective education and gender equality is very important for good governance. It can flourish our country's upcoming scenario and attain the development at a maximum level.
How good governance can flourish our society?
Definitely, it's very important that we need a very good government, and we need the kind of an authority by the government, as well as I believe in one particular statement, that is government by the people, of the people and to the people.
Tell me about something about good governance, how it can flourish our society and nation.
See, any organization cannot run without a governance, and country is such a big organization that without good governance, our nation cannot run. Good governance is very much important.
See, there are the vital characteristics for a good governance, that is accountability and sensitivity to the people's or citizens' need, and you can say transparency of the system. So if all these characteristics are there, obviously the society will flourish. If everyone is following the systems and procedures and policies in a correct manner, I think it will definitely lead to the flourishment of the society.
Flourishing society and nation.
What I believe, good governance has been always a challenge in Indian society and also in developing nations. It is not a 1 minute affair or 1 day affair or a 1 year affair. There should be a clarity in the system, what I believe. When you plan, then you should have clear ideas in your mind. Who is the customer? Who is the beneficiary? When it comes to the society, it is the common man. You have to start from there, their needs and the requirement, and you have to plan accordingly. If you start from the top and cleaning the urban, going to the rural, I don't believe so. So we have to strengthen the grassroots level, cleanse the system with bettering of bureaucracy, I believe that, deadlines. And you have to monitor how the system has been implemented.